there's a shot in pool called throw shots. And we're going to show you what throw shots are and how to make them and how to be consistent. As you can see in this demonstration, both the combination is lined up about 3 inches up the rail, and the throw shot is lined up about 3 inches up the rail. So in order to make the four ball, I've got to hit the three so it hits the four a little on my right to make the ball. But on this throw shot, it is a friction shot. It is unlike a combination. Here's what happens on a throw shot. Okay, when you have two balls frozen, or in some cases close together, it's called a throw shot. And even though when you saw the balls lined up a little bit to the right of the pocket, that we can influence where the one ball goes. We can push it offline a little bit with friction. And here's how that works. If I hit strike the cue ball 45 degrees to the line of the two balls, there's 90 degrees, there's 0 degrees, there's 45 degrees. And 45 degrees is roughly the center of this ball, the center of this ball lined up with the edge of the one ball. That angle gives the most friction to the between the six and the one ball. So here's what happens in slow motion when you strike two frozen balls at 45 degrees here. At the moment of impact, the six ball is crushed between this ball and this ball. So it squirts straight out this tangent line. And as the six starts to move this way, the friction between them pulls the one off line about 1 inch per foot in the summer, a little more in the winter when it's dry. As you can see, the outside of these balls are aiming a good 3 or 4 inches up the rail. So I want to throw the one ball to the left the maximum amount. So to do that, I have to make the six push it there. So I'm going to show you where I'm going to hit. There's dead center. Now I'm going to move around about 45 degrees, and what I'm looking at is center of this ball, and the edge of the one ball. So that's where I have to make the cue ball go to get the maximum effect of a throw. So sometimes I tell people that when I'm teaching this, to make the cue stick go around like this until you're aiming the middle of the six at the edge of the one ball. So that tells me where I have to make the six go in order to make the one ball. I have to make the six go in that direction. And here's what it looks like. I'm going to cut the six down in that direction. Watch the one ball. Now, I'll set up these two balls. Now, as you can see, both balls are to the left of the hole. So, and always work backwards and you'll never make a mistake. The six has to go to my right, therefore the three has to go to my right in order to push the six to the right. So I want to know what direction do I shoot the three. So I lay my cue across the middle of the three and the edge of the six,